Here I tell some of my friends claim that consumers who purchase items made from animal bodies, meat eaters, as murderers. Although they did not act upon killing, they are the main reason behind animals being killed. So, is consuming meat and products made of animal products bad karma, even though it is to sustain the health of oneself? Thank you. So I don't have the kind of capacity of a Buddha to investigate the ramifications of karma, but my own sense is, yes, there's a certain amount of karma, but obviously the person who kills the animal makes most of the karma. The person who raises it, knowing that it for meat, raises it to be killed, has a certain amount of karma. The person who kills it has a certain amount of karma, and the person who sells it, making profit out of it, also has a certain amount of karma, and then the person who eats it, that's what I think. It makes sense, doesn't it? Because if we were vegetarian, as this person makes, as they could make the point, they wouldn't be killing the animals. So, how much karma? The Buddha didn't say that we should be vegetarian. So he's the wisest and most compassionate person. He didn't say, as far as I'm aware, in the suttas, that you should be vegetarian. Interestingly enough, Ajahn Achalo experimented for a while at Wat Pho Po. He had some vegetarian food. He encouraged some donors to produce vegetarian food, and for those who wanted to be strictly vegetarian. And he decided against it, he said, because it would create some division in the community of those who were vegetarian and those who weren't. Well, someone asked him, is there a difference between vegetarians and non-vegetarians? And he says, yes. The difference is similar between a frog and a toad. He said, the frog is a little bit more beautiful. I mean, even if you're vegetarian, the thing about the noble truth of dukkha and the all-pervasive sadness of the conditioned realm is that even if you're vegetarian, millions of insects died to create the grains and the petrol that fueled the tractor. You know, environments were destroyed to get the petrol. It's like, you can't do anything in this realm without affecting other beings negatively. And so we try to be more harmless, and that's beautiful. We try to develop metta and act from metta. When I was a layman, I was strict vegetarian, I was vegan actually. And then when I became a monk, I trained myself to eat what was offered. I still only eat small amounts of meat because I do have a sense, I do have a feeling that it's just not nice to eat other creatures, is it? But monks, we train ourselves to be content with what we're given, and we eat what we're given. Well, if I was a layperson, I'd probably try to be vegetarian. But another thing to be careful of course, is there's all sorts of ways to make karma, and self-righteousness is a way to make karma too, isn't it? So you can be vegetarian and you might be harming us animals, but if you think you're better, and if you think the others are worse, you're making a lot of karma with conceit, and you're going to be reborn, basically, and you're going to be killing beings in future lives because grasping at thinking that you're better and others are worse. You're more pure, they're less pure. This is really dangerous. So that can be an unpleasant quality in certain vegetarians. I was a self-righteous vegetarian. My father is quite sweet. My father, he grieved the fact that I couldn't have a barbecue with him. And then I gave up alcohol as well. I think it's not really sweet. He realized that he could cook me vegetarian sausages and pour me a ginger beer. So he had his pork sausages and his barbecue, and he made me vegetarian sausages. And I said, here's your beer, mate.